Come on over, bud. Oh, man, how about that? That's some rock and roll.
Joe,
good to
you?
See you, my pal. How are you, brother?
Good.
Good, sit down.
Thank you.
Oh, that's all you're burning for you is right. You're burning up the house.
Yes, indeed.
Who has more fun than you?
Nobody.
Nobody, you're darn right.
Nobody.
You've been traveling, obviously Blue Oyster Cult traveling all over the place.
Yeah, and we still work quite a bit.
You do. You do a lot of work quite a bit. You're booked throughout the rest of the year and having fun.
Yeah, we're seeing the Southern Hemisphere now, too.
We
never got there for like 4 decades. And
you're finally doing it.
Yeah, we're doing South America and Australia, places like that.
Yeah. You know, I found so interesting when you started in music, you actually started out as a drummer.
Yes, I did.
And then you fractured your wrist.
Right.
And then you pick up a guitar.
Right.
How does that work?
Slowly at first, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. I actually started on accordion before that.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. When I was like nine years old.
But your father was a jazz saxophonist.
Yes, he still plays. He just turned 90. He's almost 91.
Is that right? Yeah. And he's still blowing a horn.
Yeah.
Because of that, was jazz more of an influence for you when you started?
Yeah, I grew up with all the big bands and then the cool school jazz of the 50s and stuff. Yeah.
And then how did you make that transition to rock and roll?
I had a crystal radio, you know. Didn't need batteries, you know, and I'd just put the headphones on and fall asleep, and I'd hear all the doo-wop and that era, you know, so I heard it all, basically.
You heard it all?
Yeah.
And you pick it up. And you go to Clarkson College up there in New York.
Yeah.
And you hook up with...
How'd you know that?
I know stuff. Listen, if the government can tap our phones, I can find out what the hell you mean. And
right.
I didn't need to tap your phone.
That's right.
You go to Clarkson College.
Right.
You hook up with Albert Bouchard, who was the original drummer of Blue Oyster Cult.
I also met my wife, Sandy.
Did you? In Clarkson?
New York. Yeah, she went to Potsdam State.
Oh, wow. Sandy. Beautiful Sandy. Yeah. And you guys start a group, Soft White Underbelly.
Actually, it wasn't the Underbelly at that time. It was a cover band.
It was a cover band.
Yeah.
And you're doing, what kind of covers were you doing?
We did Animals, we did the Blues Project is what we were really known for.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, and we did, we did a lot of pop chart hits, you know.
Your manager, so because of the popularity, you end up in a meeting with Clive Davis and Harry Nilsson.
That was our audition, yeah.
That was your audition.
Right, and Bobby Columbia from
Blood,
Sweat, and Tears.
And so you go into this great meeting. And they love what they hear, of course. You blow them away. And then Sandy Berman says, we got to change the name. You can't do Underbelly.
Well, we didn't have a name, right?
Yeah.
We were sort of in between names. You know.
So, and so he came up with Blue Oyster Cult.
Which was a song title of ours.
Right. And then on top of that, he was messing around with some of the names in the band, and he gave you Buck Dharma.
He did.
And that was a...
Still Buck Dharma.
You're still Buck Dharma.
Yeah.
And it's rock and roll.
Yeah.
Now, who were some of your musical influences? Now that you all of a sudden you say, man, I really wish I got a chance to.
Well, you know, I started out as a surf guitar player, and you know, all of Carl Wilson, which is basically, you know, Chuck Berry through Carl Wilson, you know, and we started listening to the. San Francisco acid rock bands, you know, and we were from Long Island, but we sort of imagined ourselves, you know, the last of the great acid rock bands. And then, you know, we didn't get heavy until the BOC days. So, yeah.
Well, the thing that disturbs me the most is that you guys are not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And I think if the... the criteria is music appreciation, but also longevity, and what you can do now. And I mean, you're selling out places all over the world that we're really hoping that you would come down to the Southern Hemisphere and continue that plan. I think that's a big tribute to you.
Yeah, well, we still love to play and sing, you know.
And we're so glad to have you.
Great.
And you got more information and to catch Buck, you can go to BlueOysterCult.com, but you also go to Buck's website. at buckdharma.com. Buckdharma.com. Don't miss it.